Hello again, everybody. Welcome to our Thursday Thought segment. I'm Pastor Dave Deckard, and we're going to say goodbye to the gospel of the week before and look forward a little bit to the one to come. Now, last Sunday, we had the latter part of John 15, where Jesus gave the commandments to his disciples that said, abide in love, abide in me, love one another. That's how people are going to know that you are my followers. But also, in the midst of that gospel, he gave them a little line which we just touched on Sunday, but we're going to look at more here, where Jesus said to his disciples, I no longer call you my servants. Really, that would have been my slaves in the Greek, but I call you friends. And I call you friends because we love one another and you love me and one another. That's the basis of our friendship. Now, when we hear friend, we tend to think of someone we tend to like. You know, we have something in common with someone, or we care about them, and so we're their friends. And we say, I'm friends with you as long as this stays true. That's not exactly what's happening in this gospel. There is a condition on it that this friendship is based on love, but it's less a personal affinity and more a raising of status. You are no longer below me, Jesus says. You are no longer an object that I instruct or manipulate or whatever it is that we think we do with people we consider beneath us or servants. Instead, you and I are looking each other right in the eye, and I elevate you and I call you friend. Now, a sneaky part of the reason we like defining friendship as just people we like is because it is easy to pick up and drop them. As I said, as soon as you don't like someone, you no longer call them your friend. Jesus calling us friends does not mean that he likes us. In fact, our lives are just as broken, we're just as messed up, we do as many things wrong as we always did. Jesus doesn't call us friends because he likes us. He calls us friends because that's what love does, even when you don't have a huge personal affinity with the person, or even when you don't think that person is perfect. That's also the kind of friends that Jesus calls us to be with the world. God doesn't love you because God likes you or agrees with you. God loves you because that's what God does. We're not called to love or be friends with the world because we like the world or agree with the world. We are called to be friends with and love the world because that's what God's followers do. And when we realize that commitment and that responsibility in being called Jesus's friend, we also come to realize the way we are to conduct our lives and the relationship in it. It's a beautiful elevation from servant or slave to friend, but it also comes with a lot of responsibility for us to fulfill. We cannot claim the first, I am really special and God loves me, without also claiming the second, therefore, I have a responsibility to share that love with all the people around me, whether I like or agree with them or not. When we do this, we will be closer to walking God's path than we were before. And when we care about the world, we will also become more in tune with the potential in us and the purpose for it in the world. That's it for this Thursday. John 17 is up next, where Jesus prays a long prayer for the aid and help of his disciples. We will talk to you about that on Sunday. Between now and then, you can always find us at lightofthespirit.church, where you will find videos and podcasts and other things, and a forum to discuss all this or whatever else you want to talk about when it comes to God, faith, or church. Until Sunday, we will see you then.